Hey guys, welcome back to Free Motion Friday. This is our third week together already. I can't believe this is going so fast. So today we are going to continue working on our free motion patterns as we continue our navigation through scripture. It's been so much fun to do this going through scripture with you guys. I hope you're enjoying the faith journey as much as I have been. So today we are going to be working on a free motion pattern inspired by Rahab. Joshua in chapter 2, verse 11 says, "We heard, and our hearts melted within us. Everyone is utterly dispirited because of you, since the Lord, your God, is God in heaven above and on earth below." Now, these words were uttered by Rahab, and I love them because her people that she were, where she was living, they weren't Christians, but she was. She had heard the power that God had, and she was moved. So when Joshua and his troops came, she secretly brought them in. She put a scarlet rope, that's what she's known for in scripture as having, put the rope outside her window. That's how they entered the city, and her family were saved. So that's what we're gonna be working on today. Let's get started. As we create our pattern, here's four tips to keep in mind. First is to have distinct starts and stops to keep your corners nice and sharp. Second tip, overlap the edges of your rectangles as you create new shapes. Third tip is to try to keep the spacing between the rectangles somewhat even. You don't want to have some that are very, very large rectangles and some that are very itty, itty bitty. And the fourth tip is to move around your quilt by making right angles only. Again, we want this to look like bricks, not circular bricks, and we'll do that another week. This week we're working on those straight corner 90 degree angle bricks. So as we get started, we'll talk through some of the things we have, some of our tools that we're using to get ready. So the first thing I have is my practice pad. I've got that really great link to a tutorial on how to make these. I've got some fabric here on the front, colored fabric. I went with red today. Kind of felt fitting for Rahab since she had the scarlet rope. I don't have true scarlet, but I figured the red is close enough. On the back, I'm doing the white. The white's really nice again because you can see how your stitches go once you're finished. We'll take a look at this at the end to see, should I get some eyelashes to get a really better view of how the quilting goes. And then I've got just some really thin, low loft, needle punched batting on the inside, saving these to turn them into a quilt when we're finished. I can't wait to see how that quilt's gonna turn out. On the machine itself, I've got some red thread on here. You'll see kind of over here in the corner, there's some red thread from Sulky. This is their cotton and steel line. I love this thread. Totally 100% cotton, works great, sews beautifully. And so that's what I've got both on the top and then filled up on my bobbin thread on the bottom. Let's start sewing. So one of the first differences you'll notice today is that I have a different foot on my machine. I had been using the free motion, more presser foot style where it's kind of got the pounding. I really wanted to try a different foot today. I found last time that that constant up and down movement was kind of like stunting it a little bit. So I thought today I would just try this more open design. Now this is technically not the right one I should be using for the open design. There is a smaller little foot that comes with the machine meant for, I think mine's called like a QC or a QO on my machine. I've got the Janome M7, but I like this one. I like how it's kind of got the broad foot around it. I think I can also use that as like a guide for measurement to keep my blocks spaced apart. So let's get started. The first thing we'll do, same as usual, start in the corner. I'm gonna draw my bottom thread. Let's hold on to the top one here. Get that up and out. That's a little harder to grab, huh? There we go. Okay, and we will start sewing. So the first thing I want to do is to make sure that I'm keeping my blocks, the bricks, I'm gonna call them my bricks, pretty evenly spaced here. So I'm gonna come in, and you'll see I am going back over the same spots in those bricks, because you want your bricks to be closed. No open bricks. And the nice thing about doing the brick shape is it's just a lot of back and forth, right angle design. And you are stitching over those same stitches you've already made in order to connect your bricks. So my bricks are, I would say maybe somewhere between a half of an inch and maybe, I don't know, a full inch wide. Each is a little bit different. I want them obviously to have a little bit of a different feel to it. Not ruler quilting here, not yet.
Although I have fallen in love with all the Westley rollers. I don't know if you guys have seen those, but that'll be a different video for a different day. So we are just continuing to work our way through. I'm kind of working in sections and rows. Mentally, that's how I can kind of think about this quilt. It's easy for me to do that, and then I don't miss any spots. I like how this foot is clear. It's really letting me see where I have and where I haven't been. Now I will say, just as it's probably hard for you to see where I'm going, it is a little challenging for me because with the red on red, it's harder to see exactly where those stitches were. So I bet when I flip this over, I'm gonna have some stitches, maybe not exactly where I wanted them. It's okay, it's part of the practice, right? Well, I have to tell you, I did not like the way things were going, so I made some changes. I switched out to a smaller foot. It was a little hard to see with the other one because of its size. So great lesson learned there. And I also switched over to the white side of my fabric. Again, it's just a lot easier because I'm doing red thread on red fabric. While I think the end result's gonna be very pretty with the thread blending into the fabrics, for trying to quilt it, it's a little bit more difficult. So I've switched over to the white. So I'm gonna sew a couple stitches here just so you can kind of see the movement. I think it'll be a little easier to see how we're moving. Navigating around here, so you see I'm coming back on some of those lines I already made, making my bricks, making a nice L-shaped brick there. Come back up. I don't want it to look too much like Tetris. It's definitely one of our favorite games here. We've been playing that a lot. So you can see, again, just moving very gently through the quilt, overlapping those lines as we create a nice brick structure here. So let's take a look at how things turned out. I'm gonna first start on the red side, the side you're not gonna see anything on. But you know, I actually really do like the way this blends in together, and I think this is definitely a tone-on-tone technique that I would definitely use on a quilt going forward. What I like about it is it lets the fabric shine through. In this case, the thread work is not overtaking the pattern. I know this is a very simple pattern, right? Like white dots on a red fabric, but the thread work isn't overpowering it. In this case, it's a nice design that really settles in and lets the fabric shine through. Now, if we flip it over to the back, you can really see this pattern. So if you look, you can see the spacing overall is okay. I would definitely say of the three patterns or the three designs we've tried so far, for me, this was the hardest. And the hardest part for me was keeping those angles straight. If you remember last week in the video, and I'll put a link to it up top here, I used a fabric that had grid lines on it. It looked almost like, there's a name for that type of fabric, gingham? That may not be right. I like to think of it as like those old fashioned picnic designs. But having the lines on it made it a lot easier to quilt straight lines. Whereas on this one, I was just moving through a very white freeform design. Overall, I'm okay with it. I think you can see we started up here, and so my lines were definitely not as clean because at that point, if you remember, I was still sewing red on red and it was hard to see. As I progressed through it, I switched feet and I was able to see a lot more, and by the time we got to the bottom down here, my lines are definitely a lot more straight. They overlap more each other, so you can see actually just the progress as I worked through the pad and how you can even improve just in one sitting. I really do like this technique. In fact, I like it so much, I used it on another quilt. Let's take a look at that one. So this pattern I want to show you is one that I recently released on our website. This is our open door chapel. You can kind of see it here, I'll hold it up for you. Now, on this quilt, I, again, really liked that tone-on-tone brickwork so much that I did it here. So if you look very closely, I'll try to hold this up to the camera so you can see. I used that tone-on-tone white on white all the way through the chapel. And look how cute that looks. It looks like this little church has brickwork, like a little old adobe church. So I just love this so much. Love the way that looks. Again, with that tone-on-tone, how it blends in, but it still creates that more three-dimensional design of having small little bricks in your chapel. So great way to be able to practice it and then directly apply it to a quilt that we have. So I hope you guys enjoyed our lesson today, our practice today, not so much a lesson, but our practice together. I look forward to seeing what you create. Go ahead and leave some comments. Let me know how it goes for you. If you have any tips or tricks, I would love to hear those as we continue our journey together. We'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.